Today, the 3rd of October, we are basically discussing the parsing. Before that, remember, just we start the parsing in a different way. I think this thing in your from your data structure class, you are well aware of. If you anything you do not understand, you always ask me the question and you put on your mic and ask the question. This is one traversal. Actually, this is a tree. This is a tree. How can you say it's a, and it's also binary. How can I say, is everyone has a two child or not? And this is also, but what is this marker? This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here. Here it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here. It actually, the chronological time, it will visit the first child here, 1, then go to the left child, then the right child, again left child, last is the child 5th. This is called, I think you all know, this is called pre-order traversing of a tree. Why I am calling pre-order? This is the root of the whole tree is root is only 1. And I am visiting root first, then left child, then again go to the left, another left child, then I first visit this one, sorry. First the root, then this child, left child, then this root, right child root. Then left child, then this. I have always pre-ordered. I have first go to root, child, then root, another root, right child. This is the pre-order. And this is the post-order. There it is basically first visit this, then another child here, then this one, right. Then I will go to the root at the end. This is the post-order. So this is little variation. I can make it here also. Instead of left, I can start from the right also. That is called root first, then instead of left child I can go to the right, but generally that is the convention everywhere. The pre-order means root first and the left child first, that is the thing. And post-order also same, we can start from instead of left we can start from right child, but that is not also convention. This pre-order is basically connected to your top-down parsing. And this is, but you can say why not in order. So in order it would be, in order would be this one we traverse first. One, then this. But in order is never used in parsing. But you might be confused your both LL and LR. We are trying to get it from left hand side. But we try to find out the rules from our context free grammar. From the, try to match it from S, that is start symbol. That is pre-order. We try to discover the rule from the S, and here in bottom up, we are getting the strings of the terminals. We try to match on the from the right hand side. Try to go to the last root at the last. That is bottom up. So I found the root at the last. That is bottom up. That is bottom up parsing, or LR1 parsing, or LRK parsing. The same. LR means R means from the, I match the rule from the right hand side and try to go to the root. 1 means I look ahead only one symbol, and K means K symbol. And here it is LL parsing, root, I try to get start from S and then try to reach the lowest from the left hand child first. Try to match the string of terminals. I try to match the leftmost terminals with the S, and that is typical the pre-order traversal. So, but you might ask, in order is no relevance in parsing, and there are in order is no relevance. And another tree traversal technique you all know, that is level order, like this one first, then this one. This is also no rule. Okay, so there are pre-order, post-order, and in order, three main type of traversal. Another is level order, 4th, and also you can make both ways direction from left to right or right to left. There's 8 variations, but we require only 2. That is pre-order, that is top-down approach. From left most terminal we try to match a star symbol, and bottom-up LR parsing we try to get the rightmost to S. Root I traverse at the last, that is what. So this is basically your data structure class. This is very relevant. Any question, or should I go ahead? You can ask any question. Yes. See, this is a always this slide I always to mention. This is very important slide. This is we are here. Context free grammar. Why context free grammar? Because we need opening parenthesis, closing parenthesis. We need to match the parentheses. We need if then else statement. If then else. So for this kind of things, we have to match its brackets. We need push down automata. We need deterministic push down automata. So we need deterministic context free language. We need unambiguous grammar for this deterministic context free. But whatever you do, your maximum parsing is ON cube. You remember N is the here a number of terminals. Whenever your program is comes to terminals, it will be ON cube. But that is not at all accepting for programming language. We try to make it ON. That is possible. And all programming languages worthwhile are ON. So that is a challenge. So we have to make it ON cube to ON. That is the main challenge, and it's a deterministic context grammar, unambiguous grammar, and the rules you always know. This is a to the power n, b to the power n, and parenthesis grammar. These are the rules. This is we have basic stages we call covered. Just to remember, this is a lexical analyzer. It is done by not pushdown automata. It will, can be done, and it is done by deterministic finite state machine, and its input is regular expression. Regular expression, you know how to determine the terminal, how to determine the expressions, how to determine the variable. It starts with some ASCII character and how to integer. All are numeric, floating point, dot, full stop will be there, dot will be there. This can be matched by the regular expression, and that is after this the symbol table is filled up. Symbol table is always should be in hash table. So that it can be accessed O one time, because it will be regular access. And remember, all these variables should have everything should be about the information. So whether it is a static variable or whether it is be a global variable, and if it's a function name, what is the scope, everything is maintained in the symbol table. So that will be always checked in subsequent phases. So it is very important. That's it. The same thing I mentioned right now. So we are here. This is one of the most important stage, that is called syntax analyzer. Parsing, I have told, is ON cube, but we should make it LL parser, that is left to right, leftmost derivation, and it is a top down approach. And this LR parser, left to right, rightmost. From the right side, we try to match. It's a bottom up parser. And we know, right now we know, this is the pre-order traversal of a tree. And this is the bottom up. It is the post order traversal of it. So we have to reach, we remember post order means we reach root at the last. Yeah, these things I have told, but I have missed in classes. This here, after the successful second stage, the lexical analysis, that then is the syntactic analysis, syntax analysis. The output is, I always do the parse tree. But generally in compiler, it will be always abstract syntax tree. There is a subtle difference between the parse tree and abstract syntax tree. This is the parse tree, but they are equivalent, 1:1 equivalent. Abstract syntax tree takes less space, because you have to make it actually the data structure, you have to make a linked list of a certain kind. You know, definitely to maintain this, the whatever the space is required, space complexity is less. Here, basically, this is replaced here. Here, the both stages here is the arguments, and this is the operation point with a sum, division, star, plus. So, this is subtle differences between parse tree and abstract syntax tree, but they are same, 1:1 same. And you remember that from the string of terminals, you have to reach only one abstract syntax tree. That is equivalently sometimes so parse tree, but basically in compiler we want to emphasize abstract syntax tree. This is the difference between the abstract syntax tree and parse tree. This is another example of abstract syntax tree. You see the operation here, plus, minus here, and this is parse tree, so it takes the less space. this is basically parsing. We are here because we have to understand this portion very well. The top down parsing we know. Now this is backtracking. This is very easy. We try to match this two, which is not, we get back. We try to match this two, get back. This cannot be ON. So backtrack, though we human do backtrack in every cases, so we try to match, this is not. But in computer, the backtracking is takes not only lot of time, it cannot be ON. So we try to avoid, we'll definitely avoid, not try, we definitely avoid by backtracking, by predictive parsing. Predictive parsing, we look ahead only one symbol and no backtracking, but we have to then the tweak the grammar. We have to modify the grammar so that the rules, so that we can, by detecting only the one terminal extra, we can rules the exactly fire the rule. We cannot misfire the rule. We cannot go back and misfire the rule. So that is the trick. So the grammar has to be changed. The rules have to be changed. With little change, it can be LL1. Here we see where the backtracking. Say we have a, this is the, these are the rules, and this is the string. What we see here first, we try to match, say, try to match with BAB. The computer cannot see. We see the BCD, so okay, it cannot be done. But computer foolishly try with BAB. BAB, because B matches, it looks at only one. Now ABCD doesn't match, so backtrack. Okay, then if this, they go for this BA, like BCD, then try to match A to D. First it match, it is not possible, backtrack. Then CA, match C, then it success. So how many backtracks are there? So 1, 2, backtrack. But you might say, instead of backtrack, I alternately, but it will take time. This backtrack means, again, trace it back. So this cannot be ON. So backtracking for small state of rules, say we have designed a compiler for maybe 10 rules, then backtracking is okay. Even ON cube doesn't matter, but in our standard programming languages, maybe 1000 rules, so backtracking is not possible. That's the same. Here, basically we see it's a pre-order, and see this is a parse tree or abstract syntax tree, the same. We try to first, this is the start from, try from S, that's the start. Try to match the left child, leftmost child, then it go to the leftmost child, as if we are go to reach this terminal. This is the from LL1. Say leftmost first terminal, we try to match the rule by the left hand side firing one by one, and this is nothing but it is a pre-order and death first. See, it go to the death first. A top down person is nothing but a death first, this thing. A top down person recognize the first token in the input. It's a death first. Anytime if you have a question, please, I check your WhatsApp. Please put up a question here. I am waiting for any question you can ask me here. So this is very interesting. So let's see, and reversely bottom up. Bottom up, we have a say, these are the terminals, the string of terminals. We try to match from here, we try to go to the S. The bottom up parsing method considers the rules syntax in post order, that I have told, in the post order. Yes. See, just try. These are rules, and your string is AAAB. So by the, we'll do it in both top down and bottom up. So we see it here is AB, and then see here we try to make this rule last, we will put E. So these are the rule order we fire, and one good thing is no backtrack, because by seeing the hey, we can fire only this room, but here we can fire this and this, that we have to hear the last point. So here if some case it may be backtrack because confusion is there. If, generally we detect by fast operation, so we all the left hand side rule will make fast and follow. Fast means if we make a first of any terminal, first of terminal means whichever terminal will come first, B, and this string whichever terminal it comes it will be. So the two rules, the first means if you put the first operation as same, so then the parser is confused. If the first operation of all the rules is disjoint set, say if it if this rule first operation give B and this rule first operation say C, then we know if we see B, we will fire this rule. If we find C, we fire this rule. So here, the first operation on the this right hand side is terminal B. First means if we put the first function on it, the which terminal will come first? B here. And here also B. And what about first of A? First of A, here A is come, and here means epsilon. Then it can be next thing whichever coming, that is called follow function of A, it can be first because A can be epsilon. So follow whichever terminal follow. But what you can see follow of here? Here follow of is B. So follow of B is first of B, that is a B. So even the first of A can be epsilon, because it's epsilon can be it's a B also. It will be clear, we'll cover it. There's a first function and follow function will determine whether your grammar is ready for LL1, but right now not required. It is a simple grammar. We see here these are the rules. We can try it from the bottom up version also. Same rules, we try to make it bottom up. So here we trick. First we put a epsilon here to match this rule. And put epsilon first we have to put a, this is called handle. I have to put handle epsilon in such a way we can go to the top and we can fire the rules. And until and unless you put up epsilon, you cannot. You can ask why not put up epsilon here. If I put up epsilon here, I can get A. That doesn't help me to get it here. So if I put epsilon here, then I can put this rule. I can fire. First I this rule, then this rule I can fire. This way I can go to this. So this is bottom up parsing. If you compare it, this is top down, the same string, triple AB, top down and bottom up. But here we cannot see much distinction, because here we try to match from A side. It looks much simpler. For human side, this is much simpler. And for the machine side, you will find it will be simpler. Bottom up parsing is for machine, it is some understanding is different. Let's see. Yeah, it is two types of parsing, top down and bottom up. But we take only the left hand side, the top down parser. Top down parser, one is brute force. That brute force means you go any rules, we don't have to change the rules. Only things that rules should be no unambiguous. That means it's unambiguous grammar. You know, the language can only be unambiguous if you have find any grammar which is unambiguous. And we don't need the fast function will be different or not. So we don't have to any grammar, deterministic context-free grammar, unambiguous language, unambiguous grammar. With full backtracking, you can parse anything successfully. But only problem will be the complexity will be O n cube. And backtracking is time costly, it takes space. So we have to modify the grammar, so that we try to get it to the non-recursive descent. So this one, this is our target. Then we have to make so that all rules right hand side which should start with a different terminal. That the first function of all rules should be different, so that we know by looking ahead only one terminal we can fire that particular rule. So grammar has to be modified. This is here grammar. Do not have to modify it. Brute force it can go n cube. Space complexity may be higher. I only the time complexity say. Space complexity, more space may be required. You can backtrack. You can go backtrack not on the first level. Maybe you go to the deep level, then you can backtrack. So, but one good thing, you don't have to modify the grammar. Grammar looks natural to any human being. So, but it will be tough for computer for parsing or making the parse tree or abstract syntax tree. And here we have to make it a we have to change the grammar a little bit so that every right hand side of the rule start with a different terminal, kind of a S grammar. You know, remember S grammar means right hand side always starts with a different and all are variables. Here I am not going into the whether it has to be Chomsky's normal form or Gravec normal form, because it is a context free grammar. That's all. Chomsky's normal form and Gravec normal form is good for computer, but it is not very understandable from human side of the programming language. So that is the thing. The language, the programming languages framework, whatever we see in C language, if we put it in everything in Gravec normal form, so your rules will be look odd for human understanding, same as a Chomsky's, because right hand side will be two variables can be and other is terminals, so rules will be not understandable, human understandable. So we do not say that all the grammars rules under context free grammar, any variable can go to epsilon, but in context, in Chomsky's normal form, you remember only S can go to epsilon and right hand side can be two variables only or one terminal. But any programming language, if you put in Chomsky's normal form, it looks strange. It is difficult to program. So Chomsky's normal form is not going to here. It is a context free grammar. There should be unambiguous grammar. So that's it. I think anything you can understand, you can ask me the question. Any question, please? Yes? Make your mic on and question. Hello? Hello, are you getting me? Is it visible? I am audible? Yes, any question? Debaruti? I'm just taking the Shivangi, are you there?
Good. Yes, sir.
Question, any question, please? So that we are understanding, any question you can ask. Please ask question. I am open for question now. Yes, Orijit, Deblina, please response.
No, sir, no question.
No question. It is not possible. Parsing one of the toughest. It is. I am not able to make you understand. That is my fault.
Sir.
Yes, question. Question.
Sir, why do we use bottom up parsing, not top down parsing?
Yes, very good question. That is the thing. Basically, both are you are using for top down parsing. Good question. Please keep on question, otherwise difficult. See here, I'm going back. See here, bottom up parsing. Question is your okay. Coming to this. Yes. Is this diagram is visible to you? Is this diagram?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Actually, this thing, it will be clear to you. This whole set is the deterministic context-free grammar. Within the deterministic context-free grammar, there are some portion is there which is unambiguous grammar. Whatever you try, you cannot get a unambiguous grammar. So, we have to cut it. Sorry. We have to this portion of the grammar, we cannot use this language, okay? Because it will give a different parts to it. Now, we can have unambiguous grammar. But the problem is, this is a LL0, and this is LL0 means the top-down parsing, and LL1 means top-down parsing with one look ahead, okay? This is the set of languages we can cover, but if you see it here, say LRK, that is a LRK language, LRK, and if you see the LLK, so compare the diagram, this is LLK, this is LLK, and this is LRK. So, LLK is a top-down parsing. So, if we say no, we will use only the top-down parsing, that is very easier to understand. But you can start from S and go by left child first, and you come to the terminals, first left terminal, then you try. That is top-down parsing, and that is LLK. LLK means you can always look ahead one, more than one. K can be 1, 2, 3, 4. And here LL0 never used. LL0 means you cannot look ahead, because you know from the Turing machine and all this thing, you have to at least look ahead only one. So, if from LL0 to LL1, see lots of power is there. More languages can be covered to 0 and 1. So, always look ahead. If you say there is look ahead grammar LL1, but if you can look ahead more symbol from LL1 to LLK, you see the more said languages you can discover. But see, LRK, that is the bottom up parsing, always LR1 is much bigger set than LL1. In fact, superset of LL1, and LRK is much better set. So, LRK, we can have a much richer language set. So, whenever you have a richer language set, means that construct you can use in programming language. So, your programming language will be more readable. See, you see from go from C to Java to Python, so language should be more readable. So to make it readable, human understandable, maybe that is easier for, that is better for bottom up parsing. Am I clear? Because I actually human don't have to go for parsing. Parsing has to be done by the computer, who can work a lot. So we will not go that whether it is easier to understand or not. Whether which one gives the first result, the bottom up is give more richer language set. Whenever we have a richer language set, we can, our functionality can be higher. So is that answer is okay for you? Why you go for bottom up parsing?
Yes, sir.
That is little bit of understanding. Yes, you have to read. Bottom up parsing is difficult to hand parse by your own way. Human can understand top-down parsing, that is LL1, but the problem is parsing is done all by computer program itself. In fact, this parser program is generated by a computer program. Make your microphone off, please. Please, yes, thank you. So, this parser program is generated by a program. So, human does have to, you have to just put the grammar rules so that automatically the parser program would be generated. The bottom-up program, bottom-up parsing, give a more richer language. So, your programming language is richer because you need that rich language so that your programming can be easier. Okay. So, any more question, you are most welcome. So, today I wish to conclude because I am making it more better video. You can ask any question. It is this is open to all. You can ask. Anybody can microphone on and ask, make a question. Thank you. The good question.
Sir.
Yes. Please.
Sir.
Yes. Please. Question, please.
Sir, in abstract syntax.
Yes.
Sir, in abstract syntax tree.
Correct.
Why parents are not present, sir?
Yeah.
Why
yeah. Parents okay, are okay, not okay, present? Okay. Good question. Yeah, I am coming to this. Abstract syntax tree. The. No, parents are there. Parents are there. It is not that. Parents must be there. Otherwise, the tree cannot be formed. Actually, it cannot be forest. Oh. It cannot be forest. The tree is there, but we should level root that way. So, see, if you say root, if it is a tree, parent is not there, that means it is a forest. No, but it can't be forest. You understand. Forest means a collection of trees. But it has to be merged. It's a tree, but the parsing tree and abstract syntax tree is the same. But abstract syntax tree is a representation of parsing tree in that form so that it takes ultimately it will be the linked list. You can say double linked list. So it takes less space. I am trying to. This is it. Here also, see, I have not mentioned the parents. So these two trees same. These two trees same. Instead of this, always remember the leaf is always arguments and all the action happening on the node. Whether it is a multiplication, division or assignment. So this is the, your action is going on at node and your argument is this. This is abstract interest tree and this must be same as parts tree. Is it clear? So definitely they are linked together all. Any question? Good question again. Please ask this type of question. It is not so trivial. This is a typical question would be asked in any interview or in your class test. What is the difference between abstract syntax tree and parts tree? Sometimes we mix these two terms, but they are same. Abstract syntax tree takes less space, so space complexity is less, so that we are using abstract syntax tree. But that has to be after the parsing, the both are same. But we should not keep the double copy. We always maintain, whenever we say tree or parts tree, we in compiler will say it will be abstract syntax tree. Good question. Any more question? Two question, I got it. I prefer more question, please. Otherwise, it will be one way because this is the toughest area. It is not easy. This is not easy.
Is recent?
Yeah, please. Question,
sir,
please.
Is recent decent parser?
Yeah. Recursive decent parser.
Recursive decent parser.
Yeah.
It used backtracking.
Yeah. This is another good question. First of all, see, this is parsing. This is backtracking. Backtracking and brute force parsing same. Okay. So whenever you say brute force, top down parsing and backtracking, it is only few rules are there. Then backtracking is okay, but it cannot be O(n) definitely. It can be O(n)Q. Then the predictive parser, there is two. One is recursive descent. One is without recursive descent. Actually, we'll try that. We should not be recursive. Recursive takes time. So it should be non-recursive. No. This parsing. I'm coming to this. Yes. This will be clear. This actually will target. This one gives O(n). This is the O(n) cube, O(n) to O(n) cube, definitely not O(n), O(n) cube. This is also can go to O(n) cube, recursive descent. So, non-recursive descent is LL1, okay? There will be no backtracking, but there your rules has to be modified, okay? So, your rules of the grammar has to be changed. So that it can be, so there you have to understand first function and follow function. What is first function? First function says if we FIR is first of any variable on right hand side, if they will give a set of terminals, the first function of all rules, a set of terminals should be disjoint. So that seeing the terminal like sgrammar, we know which rule to fire. But that is a necessary condition. That is not a sufficient condition for LL1 grammar. We'll come in the next class, or I'll making a preparation video. So what is the conditions for LL1? But one condition definitely, the first should be different. Okay. So any more question? Good question again. So I will go, got what is recursive descent? I have not gone very detailed into recursive descent. Recursive descent, you can get a little bit of backtracking is there. It can go. So we basically no backtracking, and by looking at only the one terminal look ahead, we can fire the exact rule, and so that it can be O(n). So I am not giving example right now. I don't have right now example of recursive descent. I'll try to give. I've already given brute force. That example I've given today, and non-recursive descent, top-down parsing, which is very very important. Because whatever tricks we go for top down, we'll use the same trick in bottom up parsing. That is a very important of the our top down parser.